This video will discuss the solutions to special types of equations that are called identities and contradictions. Identities and contradictions can come in many forms, but the examples you're going to see here all start out as linear equations. So first of all, what is an identity? Well, an identity is an equation for which every number is a solution. We say the solution set to the equation is all real numbers. So here's an example, x plus x equals 2x. And the reason this is an identity is that no matter what number you plug in, it's true. For example, if you plug in 5, I'm pretty sure 5 plus 5 is 2 times 5. Those are both 10. 3 plus 3 is 2 times 3. And you could go on and on and check every single number you can think of, and that will be a solution. So anything where every single number in the world is a solution, that's called an identity. Now, what's a contradiction? Well, it's sort of the other extreme. An equation for which no number is a solution is called a contradiction. And when you have a contradiction, the solution set, some people say it's the empty set, other people prefer to write no solution. But the first example I have here is x plus 1 equals x. There's no number in the world that's going to make that true, because when you add 1 to a number, it changes it. So if I take a number like 5 and I plug it in, 5 plus 1, and I compare it to 5, there's no way those are equal. If I take 0, 0 plus 1, that's not equal to 0. So no matter what I try, I can't find a solution. That's called a contradiction. So how do you know when an equation has no solutions or infinite solutions? What happens in your work is that if you're solving the equations and you arrive at a point when all variable terms disappear on both sides of the equal sign, then you either have a contradiction or an identity. Identities leave values that are equal. Contradictions leave values that are not equal. So let's take a look. So in this first example, we're asked to solve this equation. And at first glance, you may not notice anything special about it. 2 times the quantity x plus 4 minus 3 equals 2x plus 5. So if we were to go about solving this, I'd have to distribute, get 2x plus 8 minus 3, and then the right side is 2x plus 5. After I distribute on each side, I collect my like terms. On the left side, I'll have 2x, positive 8 minus 3 is plus 5, and on the right side, I have 2x plus 5. Well, you might notice at this point that those two sides are identical. Turns out if they're identical, the equation is an identity. But let's say you didn't notice that they were exactly the same and you went through the process of trying to solve this. Well, if you solve this, you're going to have to subtract 2x from both sides. And then what you have left, well, on the left side, all of your x's go away. And on the right side, all of your x's go away. And so what you have left is just numbers, and you have a true statement. So if you have a true statement, the equation is an identity, and we say the solution is all real numbers. All right, let's take a look at the next one. 3 times the quantity x minus 4 equals 3x plus 10. If I distribute here, three times x is 3x. 3 times 4 is 12 with a minus sign in between. And then I have 3x plus 10. Okay, so the left side and the right side are not identical. So I could proceed and try to solve this, and if I did, I would have to subtract 3x from the left side and subtract 3x from the right side. And when I do that, again, my x's disappear from the left side and I'm left with a negative 12. My x's also disappear from the right side and I'm left with a 10. Well, negative 12 is not equal to 10. So that means if this is impossible, there's no way that negative 12 can ever equal 10. It means the thing that you started with could never be equal. So this is a contradiction, and that means there are no solutions. Let's look at one more. Or maybe we have two more. 2 times the quantity x plus 1 plus 3 times the quantity x minus 4 equals 5x minus 7. If I distribute, 2x plus 2 plus 3x minus 12 equals 5x minus 7. Now before I start moving things from side to side, I'm going to combine my like terms. I've got a 2x and a 3x, so that's a 5x, and I've got a plus 2 and a minus 12, so that's minus 10, and then I have 5x minus 7. All right, so those are not identical, but if I wanted to solve this, I would subtract 5x from both sides, which would leave me with negative 10 equals negative 7. And I'm pretty sure those are not equal. And so if those are not equal, this is impossible, which means the original equation was impossible, so we write no solution. That's a contradiction. Oh, one more. Okay, x minus 3 times the quantity x plus 8 plus 4x equals 2 times the quantity x minus 12. I'm going to be careful here. When I do this distribution, I'm just distributing this negative 3. And on the right side, I'm distributing the 2. So I think I'll have x minus 3x minus 24 plus 4x. That's my left side. And on the right side, I have 2x minus 24. Okay, combining my like terms, I've got an x, a minus 3x, and a plus 4x. I think that is 2x. And then I still have the minus 24. And on the right side, I have 2x minus 24. Hey, those are absolutely identical, which means this equation is an identity, and that means that every number is a solution. So you could at this point write all real numbers. If you didn't notice that they were identical at this point and you tried to solve, your variables would disappear and you would have the exact same number on both sides, which is always true, which means the original equation is always true, and at this point you write all real numbers. Again, that equation is called an identity. The solution is all real numbers. Okay, the last thing that I want to talk about in this video is the difference between a contradiction, an identity, and an equation that actually has a solution that's x equals 0. Sometimes people get all of those confused. So again, no solution means that it's impossible to find any number that makes the equation true. An identity means every number in the world is a solution. And if you have a solution of x equals 0, it means that there's only one number that can make the left side of the equation equal to the right side of the equation, and that number is x equals 0. So if I go to work these out, notice that if I solve this first one and I subtract 2x, I get 3 equals 3. I have no variables, but a true statement. This is called an identity, and the solution set is all real numbers. And again, you may have noticed ahead of time that this original equation right here, the left side and the right side were identical. So you could have concluded all real numbers at that point. For this one, we don't have an identity, but if I try to solve it, I subtract 2x. Again, all of my variables disappear, and I'm left with 3 equals 1, which is a false statement. 3 can't equal 1, which means the original equation can never be true. So this is a no solution. And then this last one, sometimes people get confused about when the numbers disappear as opposed to the variables. So if I go through and I solve this one, I'm going to move this x over. So I'm going to subtract x on both sides. And then I'm going to have x plus 3 equals 3. And since I still have a variable, that means I'm going to have a solution. In these other problems, I didn't have any variables left. In this particular case, if I try to isolate my x, I have to subtract 3. I still have a variable on the left, x, so that means I've got a solution. It just so happens that the solution, 3 minus 3, is 0. So that's very different. This is an equation in which there's only one number that makes the equation true, and that number that makes the equation true is 0. And you'll notice that if you substituted it in up here, 2 times 0 is 0 plus 3, that's 3 on the left, and 0 plus 3 is 0, that's 3 on the right. So that's a quick review of identities and contradictions.